Government accountants, you know what? They gotta have circus training because I think they juggle the books and the people they work for, the elected politicians, they too must be out of the circus because for the most part, they're a bunch of clowns. Hey, just sharing with you. Now in Ottawa, Canada is talking about clowns and left-wing politicians and so on. The left now is looking at having mandatory voting to re-engage the citizenry into the political system and reinforce democracy. This is the advisor, he's an academic person, and he's the advisor to the Liberal leader, Justin Trudeau, the want to be next Prime Minister of Canada. Okay, then let's analyze that. So we're going to protect the democratic system by forcing you to do something you don't want to do, obviously, because you don't do it now. And that's democratic. These guys, I tell you, they're walking among us. Somebody's got to get rid of these liberal people because they're just too dangerous. Blah. Okay, in Canada, still all three leaders of the main political parties, they're all on side with this little, I don't know, socialist thing that keeps going on because they say we as a group want to have this happen and that happen, so that's what we're going to do. They don't pay any attention to what the public wants. Abortion, 70% of all Canadians, poll after poll after poll, want some type of restriction on abortion, and the government says, but we don't, so you can't have it. 82% of Canadians want to have capital punishment, or certainly the right to have it, and the politicians say, but we don't, so you can't have it. And they talk about a democracy, not so fast, and it's a real tragedy is what it is, let me tell you. Somebody's got to fix that. I wish some politician would man up and say, hey, it's about you. It ain't about me. All these entitlements and everything else that we have, and we don't do anything for you. We're going to change that now. My, oh my, you know what would happen? He'd get elected, or she. 45% of all small business in the United States of America now have held off hiring because of Obamacare. Taxpayers will be hit now with $870 billion so far in additional taxes because of Obamacare. Families now can expect to pay an average of $306 a month now, more than what they used to before, and they no longer have a choice. Democracy, hey, is it running wild? I don't think so. That's got to be just the opposite of that. In Canada, they've been fooling around with that for quite a while. I mean, you know what? You don't have a choice, and they're still fighting about it every day. And Canadians, again, back to what I was saying earlier, they want to have a choice. They want to, and the politicians said, but you can't. Who do they work for anyway, these politicians? The Canadian security watchdog people. Recently, they came out with this. They said, investors, you be careful. Be wary of publicly traded companies with ambitions to grow and sell medical marijuana because some of the stocks go up and some of the stocks go down. Duh. Watch out for scammers, they go on to say. Well, Bay Street and Wall Street, that's kind of where most of them are anyway. And you're advising the public? I mean, if you ever tried to buy a stock from a broker, there's so many sentences and paragraphs and pages that say, beware and do this and do that. It's kind of like an audit. The first page tells you that everything in there might not be right. But pay me a big bill. But if anything is wrong, don't call me. I'm now over to chartered accounts, but you know where I'm going with this. Back to this. Who are they to do that? It's not good for the people in the business that are doing well, because all they've done is spook people. Not necessary to spook people. People can take care of themselves. Quit trying to, I don't know, protect us from ourselves, you liberal people. Vancouver, this is real liberal. The school board there recently has approved, it's already done, it's a done deal, a policy change aimed at accommodating gender identity and sexual orientation. More liberals trying to get into somebody else's life and head. These are kids, six-year-old kids, seven-year-old kids, and they're saying, hey, we don't know if you know if you're a boy or a girl. Duh, I do. Look at them. Hey, but you might be mixed up. So on the doors, we're not going to have his and hers anymore. We're going to put little signs and we're going to call it different names. And we're not going to call anybody a boy. Not going to call anybody a girl. The school board forged ahead with this, even though the parents didn't want to have it happen. And they got these new pronouns they're using. A last minute amendment even mandated that XE and XERA and XYR can be used instead of he and she. Kids can't understand. I can't understand that. I mean, what's wrong with these people? They're trying to call something something else. It reminds me of many years ago with the school bus back in the 60s in Alabama, and a guy said, the bus driver, he said, oh, you black people get in the back of the bus and you white people get in the front of the bus. A guy came along and he said, come on, treat everyone the same when you call your pronouns and different things. And how dare you? He said, hey, no problem. I'll call everybody green. Is that fair? Everybody can be green, the same color. That's a great idea. And the bus driver then said to everybody, dark green people get in the back of the bus and light green people at the front of the bus. Y'all come back tomorrow. We'll get more for you from the right. See ya.